I will start with introduction of my person. So I'm working for DTIQ. It's a company that originated from here, from Gliwice. It was created by people from Politechnika Śląska. And they created a successful product. And then, as usual, we were both by USA company, so now we named DTIQ. More about company later. I'm working here as a technical lead in computer vision team in data science department. Also, I'm lecturer at Jagiellonian University. I come from Skawina, it's a small town near Krakow. In private time, I collect tickets. There is some interesting thing. Gliwice had its own public transport tickets for a very short time in the 90s, in the latest century. It is also another interesting thing that for trams that were separate tickets, and now we don't have trams in Gliwice, but a few years ago they were, and we still have in Gliwice a working tram depot, despite the trams are not working through the city. And going to the main topic, the company is working on the in the QSR industry. It is for quick service restaurants, so McDonald's, Burger King, etc. And the main goal is to identify frauds or something other. Wrong behavior that is not expected, for example, by employees and also by clients. This part is currently made mostly manually, so we have a huge team of auditors that take a video from the given restaurant and analyze this video and search for frauds and other mistakes. So we try to automate some this process in many ways. A part of this, we constructed solutions to monitor clients' behavior in restaurants and. It also is connected with, for example, speed of service, so how long they are waiting for their meal. I told that I work with computer vision department, so my part of work consists only with videos and images, so the input data for our research are camera views from surveillance monitoring, and we also have other department that works with data that comes from transactions, but this is not my part, and I will skip this topic in my talk. The first area of our work is maintenance of current product that were already released and are working in locations around the world. Actually, we have clients. The most of clients we have in Hispania and in USA. The products are speed of service, so we measure the time clients wait for their order. Entry exit monitor is a tool that counts people that are entering and going out from the restaurant. Occupancy monitor is a product that was developed in the COVID time, so to measure if the limits are not overhead. And we also have introduced a tool that also measures speed of service outside, so on the drive-through installations. We also are actively working on new solution and improvement of existing solutions. The very important part is architecture modification. So we use in our work neural network models that are based mainly on YOLO V3, but we also tried different architectures, and the goal here was to simplify the inner architecture of the network in the way to speed up the interference time, but not lose accuracy too much. Why? It's because we need to have our tools to be run in not the modern systems because of money. So the product must be affordable for most restaurants, so it cannot be too expensive, so we cannot rely on the cloud, we cannot buy for each restaurant expensive graphical units and computational clusters, etc. So we need to have our models working on CPU or with even maybe a small additions like edge devices. So our main limitation is that we need to have our products to be working with limited requirements. So we tested different architectures, we achieved some improvement, but we also achieved expected inference time that was, we wanted to achieve 5 FPS, so we achieved them by converting models to TensorRT. And on the other hand, we also tried with converting models to OpenVINO, and it also succeeded. The other part is speed of service improvement. I will talk on this example more later, also regarding dirty tables reporting and unattended cash drawers. I also mentioned automatic segmentation. It's a project that we want to automatically divide the, as we see the whole area inside the local, and we can divide this area for parts where we have part for staff only, so they are preparing them our meals. We have area with tables when clients are eating. So, and we also have the central place where people are waiting for their order. So we need to distinguish those areas because in each of area we need to use different metrics and different models. So the problem is that if we scaled, so if we make a massive rollout for new locations, each particular location has been configured manually with those, we name it zones. So we need to segment this area into particular zones, and currently it is done manually, and we want to automate this process. We also work with a project that support our internal processes to also automate it somehow. The very important part of our work is annotation data, is data annotation. Currently it is not done exactly by computer vision team because we have a separate team that is responsible for this, but I want to also spend a few time to talk about this issue because it is very important and not so easy to solve. For annotation, we use CVAT tool. It is widely known labeling tool, publicly available. And we annotate, you can see on this image that we may have a very large number of objects to be annotated on a single image and of many categories. We use different categories in different areas of our work, so we need to identify people, it's for speed of service. For table cleanliness, we need to identify tables. We also identify much more different categories, for example, phone. We make differentiation with between people who work here, so for workers and for customers. We have differentiation for tables. So we need to annotate separately clean tables and need to annotate separately dirty tables because it is important if the table is clean and ready to. For another client. For drive-through, we also make differentiation between different type of vehicles. So we identify buses, trucks, motorcycles, and normal cars. We also often use additional attributes. So, for example, for drive-through, we annotate if the car is visible from the front, from the back, from the back side, the color of the car. Also, we need to notice the weather condition in the moment. So, because our solution must work at day, at night, at the with a snow, with a rain. So all of those conditions produce different camera views. So we need to train models to cope with all of them. I have mentioned zones. Zones is a concept that limits our computation, our detection analyze to a particular area. Here we see that the area of waiting, so the area that where clients go and wait for the order. We also defined other zones. They not always are polygons. We also use zones that are defined as single points or cycles. It depends on the clients, the people behaviors on the area and how we want to calculate their presence in the zone. The problem that we have always if we start to annotate data for new task is how many data annotate. Which location is used to annotate, how many locations, and how many images at all. Should we use images with low traffic or with high traffic? Also, the traffic level depends on the time of the day and also on the location. So we have locations that where we have a bunch of people every time, almost every time, and we have locations where we have one people, two people per hour, and it's sometimes normal for this branch, from this brand, for this location. It is not a clear solution for this. Actually, it is almost always a compromise between our expectations and the possibilities among annotation teams, because each annotation takes a time, and it always takes more time than we expect. During annotations, we can face many problems that are often more very detailed, but we have to somehow manage and have some decision how annotate such problematic objects. So we can have occluded objects, so one person is behind the other, or behind a table, behind something, anything. Objects that are partially visible, so when I stand behind the table, you cannot see my legs. Yeah. Objects that are grouped, so there is often a misdetection by model when many people group very close to each other. The detection models often recognize it is recognize them as a single person, and this is a big problem for us because we need to calculate each person individually. So we need to distinguish each person. The other problem is distant objects. So I will go back again to this slide. And this is not too good, but for example, if we want to work with speed of service problem, we need to calculate people that are in the central area. Yeah, but we have sometimes people on the here, on the very distant, they are very small, so can be also difficult to annotate precisely. Also, in the speed of service problem, we don't need to detect them correctly or because it is not the case. So we also need to cope with such problems. We also have cases that are very project specific. So for example, if we have a table cleanliness problem, so when we decide the table is clean and the table is dirty. Is this table clean or dirty? Yeah. Because there are things that should be there. So it should be considered clean. But there is something on this. So we have similar problems in restaurants. To speed up the annotation process, we also introduce the trick that we perform detections initially by automatic model, and then annotators assess them manually and correct if the detection is wrong. It is particularly important in re-identification and tracking issues when we need to not only annotate each people on the scene, but we also need to know their ID and compare with ID from the previous scene. Because the annotation team not also creates, they prepare annotate data for model training. It is particularly much easier that the second very important task that we need to evaluate our models, and we need manually assessed data to compare this with our automatic models. In this way, they annotate the whole video that, for example, takes an hour. And for each second of this video, they need to annotate people and also decide if where how those people moved. So for each people, we need to have ID. Assign it. And it is a really, really time-consuming process. Okay, going to speed of service, it's one of our projects. The main goal is to assess mean time of people waiting for order a meal or for pick up a meal that is ready. We have actually two concepts for this. The first one was already released and is work on over 500 locations. We regularly update the model with new onboardings. And it is based on simple model object detection. We are currently working also with more advanced solution that will also track each people, and we will be able to calculate speed of service individually. Okay, here is an example from the currently working solution. So we have a simple object detection model, and you can see the polygon zone that represents the waiting area. Actually, we are counting people inside this area. They are marked as dark blue. If you maybe seen, the detected occupancy time doesn't change with each frame because it is in production taken with 10-second snapshot. So we take one snapshot per 10 seconds, calculate number of detection peoples, and multiply by 10 seconds to achieve the... Of course, it is not exact, but it is a compromise. So the accuracy of this solution is good enough for our needs, and we it is difficult to make snapshot more often due to technical difficulties. I need to mention that on the single processor, not only single stream is working, because we have speed of service, we have entry-exit monitor, we can have a few, two, three, four entries to single restaurants, so all of them must work simultaneously. So that's why we are not able currently to take, for example, real-time measures. The green one is area of order, so or pickup. We are measuring the time the people are spending in the waiting area, and we are measure the time that people are spending in the order area. Here is the same problem, but a bit harder example. You can see here on the middle of the waiting zone. Yeah, it's a backpack. It is. It looks like a person, and it's detected often as a person. This leads to a very high error rate. We have also here on the bottom. We can see that people are visible partially, so we can see only their legs. You can see that model doesn't has some problems. So sometimes they are detected correctly, sometimes not. The other problem that we are working with is table cleanings problems. So here we want to know if a table is dirty and unoccupied. So you can see here those two close to are dirty and unoccupied, and also we have some in the deep. This is a case that shouldn't happen. So when a person is sitting by the table, it's okay. But when he finish eating, the table should be cleaned by personnel. Developed a solution that is detecting such cases. You can see now those tables were cleaned and are selected as clean. But we had such situation that those tables were unoccupied and dirty for over 5 minutes, which was set up as a time that is expected to be considered by staff to clean those tables. So it was over 5 minutes. So we have reported unclean alert. The other case study is cash drawer security. So here we have a cash drawer, so it is a container for a cash. Currently it is empty, but usually it is full of cash. It is a room for managers, for people who are responsible for this cash. And the case is that the cash in cash drawer cannot be leave without attendance. So we define attendance as a case when person is in the same room as the cash drawer. The system detects situations when when cash drawer is visible on the scene and people is not. And then the time is measured, and if a cash drawer is not attended for too long, it also is reported as an event that should be checked. Okay, here I want to thanks to the whole our team who worked with this project, and also of course we are still working on this. Robert Bęż, Piotr Kolepski, Paweł Maciołek, Damian Polak, Karolina Sikora, Dominik Tim. They are in our computer vision team. I also want to thanks to Oleksii Hokos and the whole annotation team, because without their work we wouldn't be able to do too much. And to Agnieszka Bir, who is our boss. Okay, thank you very much.
Thank you. That was very interesting, and we have quite a lot of questions. So let's start. Can you share some details on how you track detected objects on video feed, or do you count unique people in some other way?
As for speed of service, actually we are not using tracking yet. We are started test with ray identification. Why with ray identification? Because we have snapshots, so 10 seconds apart from the one measure to another measure is too long to track. That's why we started with ray identification. And we tested three well-known algorithms. We adopted them to our environment, and the results are so-so. It's not a recommended solution. We will try to speed up to make the snapshots more frequent and to try with tracking. We use tracking with drive-through project, and there it is works quite well. Yes, it is. We have good results with drive-through tracking, but we need to know that cars. It is generally more easy task because cars are larger and there are not so many cars in one scene.
Don't you think all of this is slightly dystopic?
I don't know.
Actually, I wanted to add something from myself to this. Like, do you know what is the goal of your clients? Like, is it for the corporations to detect some abnormalities? Like, you know, there was a risk that cash was stolen here, or, you know, something really wrong happened there, or are they using this to, for instance, evaluate performance of the employees? And, you know, perhaps it's easier to get fired from a place like this.
Actually, I'm not at the position to think about if it's important for clients. It's not my role. So we have clients. Clients want to do this. Clients sometimes want some very strange things. Last year we had a project when we detected Dunkin' Donuts on a shelf, and we had to report the case when when the shelf is empty, so no Dunkins are visible.
Okay, thank you. Did you notice problems with person detection working worse back when masks were obligatory?
Actually not, because if we have view from the top, there are not we don't recognize faces, so it is not a problem. Rather, the whole shape is important.
How have you decided to aim for 5 FPS on systems and not other value? 5 FPS seems quite a bit a dense solution. Why not 1 or 2 FPS?
Actually, we have a research project funded by NCBR, and we have these requirements in the project description. I don't know why it was set up, because I worked too short with the company.
Does GDPR impose any constraint on this tool? I guess if it's US, then GDPR does not apply.
No, because in case we need to the view is without any masking and blurring, etc., is sent to object detector, and object detector doesn't face it. Any blurring, etc., is done if needed later.
Did you have to re-annotate the model for new locations, or is it just marking the new region, defining type of task, but object detection model works for all?
It's difficult, because it is difficult to annotate, prepare annotate for each location. So we must rely often on annotations that we have already. It works. Of course, if we annotate new location, we are able to have model better results for these locations, and we are trying to do it, but it is still on progress because of some difficulties. And anyway, in general, objects are detected. So it is rather for edge cases that are rather maybe rare.
Do you calculate client conversions funnels via computer vision?
Actually, not.
Do you ever?
Maybe it is calculated on a production team, because I don't know exact architecture of the product that is already working, but in our team, not.
Do you ever use depth cameras to detect objects?
Don't think so.
Do you send those info about dirty tables to some dashboard map? Is it streamed there?
Not yet. This is a part of NCBR project research, so this is a proof of concept for now.
YOLO is quite power hungry. Have you considered using other architectures like newer YOLO models, V4, V5, or MobileNet?
Yes, considered, but didn't test it yet. It is in plans.
for conversion calculations, is it possible to differentiate adults from kids?
It is difficult. So currently, we are not doing this. Actually, we have problems with kids, because kids are not so Their behavior is strange for SOS needs because they go around the whole scene and they are hard to track. Yes, kids are our problem and our hard example. But for now, we didn't solve yet. Yes.
Do you use OpenCV anywhere?
Yes. Somewhere peer, but it is the same.
Could you share more details on how you have how have you modified the YOLO model?
It is a long. Actually, I had last year a whole presentation exactly on this topic. To be short, we have three types of modifications. So we changed the anchors to reduce the numbers from 9 to 6. For example, this is one. The second one was remove some layers. So slightly less layers in the detection model. And the third modification was to introduce some shortcuts.
Okay. Well, this keeps coming back. Have you been dealing with the moral of the video tracking with the client? For instance, tracking time of time when employees are on smoke or actually working?
Actually, I don't remind any situation when employee was smoking. this is not a case for our team, so we do not communicate with client directly. So,
do you combine the data from multiple cameras to reduce the errors?
Not yet.
Would it help?
Okay.
Do you think it would help a lot?
The combination may be difficult, and it is possible with re-identification, of course, and maybe it is worth to consider. But to be honest, we have only single panoramic camera for per location, so. If we want to do it, we need to combine different types of camera, so different views. It may be difficult. So it is not so easy problem. We didn't consider it yet, but maybe in future it also is worth to investigate.
Okay, it's already 1:01, so please don't hesitate to approach our speaker directly with those questions. Thanks again.
Thank you.